If they are producing at home for American markets, they should have a low tax rate. That would offset all the advantages of the cheap labor and the reduced regulation and so forth that they get abroad. That, of course, would shrink the trade deficit by the amount of the offshore goods, which is probably about half of the trade deficit with China and a substantial part with some other countries. So that would show a shrinkage in the trade deficit instead of a continual growth. This would reassure people about the dollar, and you would have less flight from it and less pressure on other currencies. The other thing they need to do is a domestic budget deficit, because the whole world knows that a $1.4 trillion deficit and rising can't be financed year after year after year. Even if the money multiplier is broken and the banks are sitting on the reserves, the net effect is going to be inflation and destruction of the dollar. And so they've got to get the budget deficit under control. The only way they can do that is to stop the wars. They would have to simply stop the war, slash the military budget. And that, again, would show people, hey, look, the deficit is going down. They are serious. We can stick with the dollar a while. We can pull in our horns. We can be less nervous. And that would give the United States a chance to recover. If they don't do those two things, it's finished. I don't know how long it'll take, but it's finished.
And we've got these vested corporate interests that feed at the welfare trough.
Right. Exactly. And they're going to block it. The military security complex isn't going to let them cut the budget. Neither is Wall Street going to let them overturn offshoring, because the offshoring produces so much extra profits.
Short term.
That's right. Short time.
Sir, we've got to go to break, but I want to throw this question out at you so you can answer it when we come back. You'll be with us till 15 after. We have most of the breaks at the end and start of the hours for listeners that are just joining us. But Rand Paul has said, cap the deficit, cut taxes, do the things you're basically talking about. And they're now accusing him all over the media, saying he's going to cause the depression. We'll be right back.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions. Yet many are unaware of the entire function of the silver lung system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs Generator. Not only does the silver lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung System at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lung System works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I was talking to Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, economist, best-selling author, former Wall Street Journal editor, father of Reaganomics. First Nations had just joined us during a break, and he said, look, well, I said, we're going to hell in a handbasket. I guess the basket's been dropped off the cliff, but it's bouncing down the cliff, and we don't know the exact route. And he said, exactly. And so that's a good way to boil it down. But he was just basically recommending the exact same things that Ron Paul, the congressman, and now his senator's son are recommending. And you notice they're the two people really being demonized by the controlled left and right. And so anybody that injects common sense sanity to this is demonized and attacked. And yes, most of the new Republicans and most of the Democrats, they don't want to discuss any of this. And so that's it. We've gone to hell in a handbasket here. Dr. Roberts?
Yes, Alex. I think that what we need to understand is something about the political system. The political system is unbalanced. And again, that was a result of offshoring. Because offshoring, which moved offshore the industrial and manufacturing jobs, diminished substantially union membership and union finances, so that the Democrats lost their unique independent source of financing. You know, when they had the unions, you had political competition. You know, the Democrats represented a social safety net, Social Security, Medicaid, unemployment insurance, the sort of things that put a floor under lives and keep income from just shrinking away and being gobbled up by the rich. And the Republicans then represented business. And so you had political competition. But when the Democrats lost their independent financing because of offshoring, they now are dependent on the same sources of finance as the Republicans. So you've got one party with two names. It doesn't matter who you elect. It doesn't matter if you elect a Tea Party candidate or not, because once the Tea Party candidate is elected and in Washington, the new member understands that to get reelected, it has to bend to the will of the oligarchy. If it fights the oligarchs, it's out in 2 years. It has no money. It can't finance itself. They'll pour all kinds of money into their candidate's campaign.
Well, to interrupt, that's what Senator DeMint in the Wall Street Journal said. He quoted former Senator Lott saying, "We're going to co-opt these people as soon as they get here." And DeMint called it bribery. But when you're able to get somebody like DeMint or somebody like Senator Rand Paul, that does scare the system, because they're in for 6 years. And it's such a powerful position that they can get grassroots funding from what's left of the middle class.
Well, I don't think there's enough of those people to change anything. And there's unlikely to be. So the fact is, there's one party with two names.
So how do we fix that?
And, well, the only way you could fix it is you would have to take political contributions out of the elections. And how are you going to do that? They're not going to pass that. You know, they're not going to say, oh, yes, let's take away all our money. And the powerful interests are not going to allow them to pass that. So it probably can't be fixed. You see what I'm saying? The political system is broken. It can't be fixed. It will have to fail. And I think the same will be the result with the economy. I don't think the people in charge have the perception, the understanding of the problem to be able to fix it. It's, you know, generals always fight the last war. And they're still thinking in terms of Great Depression or post-war recession, and they're trying to deal with the economy that way, but it's been offshored. Those economies weren't.
Doc, this was a short segment. This was a short segment, long segment coming up, final segment, for you to be able to finish up with that and then get into the overall police state, because that is our new economy. Our new economy is police state. We'll be right back.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Well, Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, who's with us for the rest of the segment, I want to get into the police state, but I just want to say this right here and not after he leaves. He is a top economist. He has a lot more knowledge than I do about the specific scientific financial systems. They claim it's a science, and so I'm probably talking out of class here, but I'll just say it. I have studied the Trilateral Commission's own reports. I've studied Club of Rome, UN, and the mega corporations are playing a game of consolidation. And if they've got to physically invade a country and kill a million people to take it over, they'll do it. If they've got to give DU weapons to the troops to win it, they'll do it. If they've got 500 mobile radiation vans that are frying the people that are operating them, not just the people inside the houses, they'll do it. And you can see this debt black hole they've created that's impossible to pay back. And the Federal Reserve's meeting, to celebrate their great victory this weekend at Jekyll Island, 100 years ago, back in 1910, they met there. And looking at it, it's delusional, kind of like Nero setting fire to Rome or, Hitler invading Russia. There's a lot of chutzpah here, but there is a method to this madness, and they're announcing this new global bank and SDRs and carbon taxes and VAT taxes to form the next bubble, and they're destroying other currencies. They're destroying our currency. I can't see it any other way than it is engineered, but you were at those highest levels or very near them of power, and I don't know what's more scary. If I'm right and it's designed and we see them all getting record bonuses and profits, everything else imploding, am I right? That's pretty scary. Or is it even more scary that they're